Let us now discuss about free fall. Now, basically the meaning of free fall is any demotion of an object which is under the direct influence of acceleration due to gravity. There is no other force acting on that except the gravitational pull of the earth. To explain this, let us take three cases. There is a building, and from the top of the building you just release the ball. This is case one, okay? And case two is you throw the object with some speed in the vertically upward direction. Case three, you throw the object in the vertically downward direction. Which do you think is the case of free fall? I would say all three are the cases of free fall. The first case, obviously you will say that it is the case of free fall. But take the case 2 and 3. When you throw the body in the upward direction, the moment you release it, the object is under the direct influence of force due to gravity. Similarly is the case with the third case, where you are throwing the object in the downward direction. Case 1 was like this. I am holding this pen, simply dropped it. Case 3 is pushing it down. Alright? So when you are throwing it down, you will be throwing the object with some initial speed. Even this case also is the case of free fall only. So the main thing what you have to remember is, when you release an object, if it is moving under the influence of gravity only, then it is called free fall. Now, let us take a numerical to understand how we apply this. So there is a building, let us say, and the building height is 40 meters. I am taking the case 1. I simply release the ball. So what are the parameters given here? Initial speed is equal to 0, height is 40 meters, and you can use S is equal to ut plus half at square. Because u is equal to 0, ut term will cancel. We can find the time taken by the ball to reach the ground. So g, I have taken 10. So when you calculate this, you are getting root 8 seconds. Now let us take the case 2. So case 2, the object is thrown, the body is thrown with a speed of initial speed of 2 meter per second. So for doing this, we have to take some sign convention. We'll assume upward direction to be positive. So the displacement is in the downward direction. So if you use the same formula, s will become minus 40. So initial speed was 2, upward you have considered positive, so it will be positive 2 meter per second into time. And when the object is thrown up, the gravity is acting downward, so acceleration will be minus g. So it will be minus 10 t squared. You are getting a quadratic equation. When you solve the equation, this is a quadratic equation. The roots are minus b plus r minus root over b square minus 4ac by 2a. So you get 2 plus r minus root 804 divided by 10. So there are two roots here. So obviously root 804 is bigger than 2. So you will get a negative value and a positive value. The time cannot be a negative value. So we are taking only the positive value. So if you calculate the positive value, you will get 0.2 plus root 8 seconds. So this is slightly more than the first case. Okay. First case was root 8 seconds. This is root 8 plus 0.2 seconds. If you take the case of the third one, in third case, you are throwing the object in the downward direction with initial speed u is equal to 2 meter per second. Here the motion of the body and the acceleration due to gravity both are in the same direction, so g will be positive here. So we can put it in this equation. You get s is equal to ut plus half at square. S will be plus 40 here. This is the initial position, this is the final position. The gap between them is the displacement. Because here we are assuming downward direction is positive, I have put plus 40. is equal to 2t plus half 10t square. Even u also I am considering positive, because in this case I have assumed all three are in the downward direction only. So we have taken positive 2. So when you solve this equation, this is also a quadratic equation. So here when you solve it, you get minus 2 plus root 8 plus or minus root 800 by 10. If you take minus, this is already minus, again minus root 800, total value will be minus, which is not acceptable. So we have to take the positive value, which is a meaningful solution. Why meaningful solution? Because if I am throwing this ball from here, it will take 1 second, 2 second, 0.5 second. It cannot be a negative value, right? So that is why we are doing like that. So here you get minus 0.2 plus root 8 seconds. Let us say this is T3, case 2 is T2 and case 1 is T1. So case 2, T2 is more than T1, is more than T3. Isn't it common sense? When you just release the body and you throw the body down, when it will take more time? When you throw the body down. And where maximum time will take? When you throw the body in the upward direction, then it will travel some distance. When you throw it up, it will go like this. So it will waste some time going in the upward direction, and from there it has to come down. So this much distance extra it has to travel. Okay? Please make a note.